Hey guys, welcome back to Chinese Zero to Hero. 今天我想教大家一些普遍的礼貌用语 polite expressions and phrases. Obviously, it's very important to be polite when speaking to others, especially in formal situations like business settings or talking to someone that you respect or someone that's older. I'm sure you know all the basics like 您、谢谢、请、对不起、不好意思、etc.But in this video, I'll teach you some more essential phrases that you may not already know. So if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. It lets me know that you want to see more videos like this in the future. 好，我们来看第一个，就是慢走，慢走。So the literal translation would be to walk slowly. Now this is used when you want to say goodbye to guests that are leaving. For example, after a house party, you can use it to say goodbye to your guests or saying goodbye to your clients or customers if you have a store or you own a restaurant.So in English, it's similar to take care or drive safe. Now let's look at some examples. 慢走，下次再来啊。Take care and come again. Another example would be 谢谢光临，请慢走。谢谢光临，请慢走。This is often used in restaurants or stores. Thanks for stopping by. Take care. Okay, moving on to the second one. 第二个，这个比较类似， it's kind of similar to the first one. It's 慢慢吃。慢慢吃。You might notice a pattern here that Chinese people like to tell you to do things slowly. So this basically means eat slowly, enjoy your meal. I think the closest translation would be bon appetit. An example would be 菜都到齐了，大家慢慢吃。菜都到齐了，意思就是所有的菜都来了。All the food, all the dishes are here. All the dishes have arrived. 大家慢慢吃。Bon appetit, everyone.Another situation would be if the host has to head out or has to leave the table for a little bit. 他可以说，抱歉，我需要出去一下，大家慢慢吃。Sorry, I need to head out for a moment. Please take your time with your meals. 大家慢慢吃。A synonym of 慢慢吃 is 请慢用。This is very common in restaurants especially because when a waitress or a waiter comes with your food, with your dish, puts it right in front of you, he or she will say,请慢用 if they're polite. 请慢用 The third phrase is 贵姓贵姓在这里贵就是 respected, honored, esteemed. 姓 as you know, is your family name or your surname. So this is the proper and polite way of asking someone's name. Remember in China, if you're meeting someone for the first time, it's polite to ask for their last name, their surname, and not their first name. So the proper way would be 请问您贵姓请问您贵姓 Or simply, 您贵姓对不起先生您贵姓 Let's say your last name is Wang. How do you answer this question? Do you say, 我姓王 Well, you can, but the actual proper and polite way to answer 请问您贵姓 is 免贵姓王免的意思就是不用不需要不需要用贵这个字不需要贵免贵 Or to put it simply, 免贵 means no need to be so formal.So the proper way of answering that question is 免贵姓王免贵姓王
哦对了我姓赵来这儿办案先生贵姓
免贵姓沈沈卫
Alright, moving on to the next one. 下一个是麻烦麻烦 To trouble or bother someone to do something.Now this one is pretty common and can be used in daily situations that doesn't have to be super formal. So it's used when you want to seek assistance from someone.
那这件事情就麻烦您了，谢谢。
So I'll just leave this matter with you then. Thanks. Another example would be instead of saying 帮我泡杯咖啡 make a coffee for me, which sounds like a command, you can make it into a polite request by saying
麻烦你帮我泡杯咖啡可以吗Could I trouble you in making a coffee for me?
The last phrase I want to teach you is 指教指教指就是 to indicate or to direct.
教 as in 教育
the fourth tone, not the first tone, is to teach. So this is used when seeking advice, seeking guidance or feedback from someone. The most common way of using it would be
请多多指教请多多指教
or...请多加指教老师请多多指教 So this is a humble way of showing that you respect the person, you think that they have more knowledge than you, and you're willing to learn from them, you're willing to take their advice.
我是个新学生今后请大家多多指教
I'm a new student. 我是个新学生。今后 from now on, from today on, 请大家多多指教。I'm looking forward to hearing all of your advice and feedback. 我对这个项目不是很熟悉。项目就是 project。不熟悉 not familiar. I'm not familiar with this project. 我对这个项目不是很熟悉。请您多多指教。Please give me guidance on it. 请您多多指教。So that's it for this video. These are some pretty essential polite phrases and expressions to use in formal settings. Just like the previous video, I also made a quiz on Google. So you can click the link in the video description and try this quiz to see if you learn everything from this video. By the way, don't forget to follow us on Instagram at ChineseZeroToHero. I'll put a link in the video description as well. We post daily content there. I think you'll like it.And also, if you want to take your Chinese to the next level, don't forget to check out our courses at ChineseZeroToHero.com. You can preview the first lesson of any course from HSK 1 to 6 on our website for free. So check it out. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.